The report, whose adoption has been pending for weeks, has finally been adopted, with Parliament asking the Minister to resign from the Office of Gender, which accords her supervisory role to the Workers' Fund. This as the committee pinned Minister Amongi to influence peddling and interference grounds she had earlier objected to.
The affairs of the National Social Security Fund be adopted by this House. Those in favour say on the contrary, nay. The ayes have it.
You decided to close, to go to government, to perform into a failed system. Stomach all the challenges. Suffer. Stay there.
Who has told you she's suffering?
Yes, I'm advising her at the speaker. Your interest was to become a minister. So, just be merciful to us.
Siluanyi.
And leave.
The minister, while giving her defense, however, assured the House that she will not in any case resign over what she called a case without any evidence. She argued that the recommendations were based on falsehood and condemned without evidence.
I want to say the truth. The truth of the matter, I approved 1.8 billion for stakeholders' engagement. When it went to NSSF, they changed it.
The 1.8 billion, you are saying the former MD wanted to give 1 billion. In order to get his way out. But in the report, your name is also listed as one of the beneficiaries. Was it also to enable him to?
So Richard Byarugaba, the former MD, wanted to use the 1 billion to give members of the board to approve his contract.
Those personalities are not here to defend themselves on the subject that we are discussing.
The minister, after several prompting questions by legislators, agreed that the 6 billion had been initiated by her, telling the committee that she had not used the funds and neither had she received it. This, however, could not exonerate her of abuse of office.
I was told the fund supports members of parliament in benchmarking.
But
I am reading my letter.
Honorable Betty, that is the wrong assertion. We budget for members of parliament under the parliamentary commission.
Now you have told me, right, Honorable Speaker, I now take that you have really clarified on this matter. But it is in my letter.
Members of Parliament are not beneficiaries of any legality or from any MDA.
Parliament, among other recommendations, dropped the lifestyle audit move, arguing that investigations would be better, saying that an audit on lifestyle would be a fishing expedition.
Save us money paid in term of bonus to staff. This money should be recovered, Honourable Speaker.
Parliament, among other recommendations, dropped the lifestyle audit move, arguing an investigation would be better, saying that an audit on lifestyle would be a fishing expedition. On the 10% remittances, NSSF fund on behalf of the board members, Parliament has recommended recovery of the money from those that directed payment with an interest rate of NSSF.
The person that authorized or caused the payment of 10% NSSF contributions to board members be caused to refund the same with interest at the NSSF rate.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.